Hi, I'm Dr. Rajasekhar M R from Chirag Global Hospitals, BTM second stage, Bangalore. Are you confused with IBS and IBD? Many people will tell I am having IBD, will be worried. Then it is actually IBS. Some people tell for IBD, IBS. Because they are so confusing and very close to each other, it is very difficult to understand. Both are totally different diseases. IBS is irritable bowel syndrome. When we call a thing as a syndrome, that means there are multiple symptoms which you are not able to fit into and we don't know the exact cause of the disease. So we call it as a syndrome. So multiple symptoms will be there, varying symptoms will be there. So is that we call it a syndrome. So IBS is a syndrome where you don't have a real disease. This is only a functional disorder we call. Bowel movements are affected, either slowed down or it is too rapid or sometimes both. Or if it is erratic, when it is erratic, you will have that bloating and all that. And because of the irritation and all that, it can have some amount of mucus falling. So IBS is that sort of disease. IBD is a serious disease, not dangerous, but it is a serious disease. It is a disease which has to be treated properly. It should not be neglected. A treatment should not be delayed. IBD is inflammatory bowel disease. There is inflammation of the intestines. In that, there are two types of IBD. One is Crohn's disease, the other one is called ulcerative colitis. Sometimes there will be overlapping of these two diseases. So again, both are supposed to be caused by immune system disorder. Our immune system, immunity, which has to protect us from foreign agents like bacteria, fungus, virus and all. It gets confused and starts attacking our own tissues, either because there is something wrong in our tissues, small changes in our tissues, or it happens on its own. So our immune system is causing inflammation. Inflammation is a sort of a reaction of the body. Whenever there is it is affected by some bacteria, some foreign agents, or because of some injury. Whenever there is an injury, there is inflammation. So without any injury, without any invasion, without any foreign bodies, if it is affecting, we call it autoimmune diseases. So this IBD is one of that sort of this one, where there is inflammation in the intestines. First it starts in the lining of the intestines, and then it can cause ulcers, when we call it ulcerative colitis, or it can cause strictures and then formation of fistula, small holes, abscesses. We call it the Crohn's disease. So these two are different diseases, but supposed to be of similar origin. So IBD is a disease which has to be diagnosed properly, confirmed and treated on a long-term basis. IBS is more of a psychological affecting the body. So these two are completely separate entities and have to be treated totally differently. So that is what we have to understand. One more thing is, people who have IBS, they'll ask, can it turn into IBD? IBS will not turn into IBD, but people with IBS can also develop IBD. People have psychosomatic disease, the symptoms are same. The symptoms are almost same. What are they? Bloating they can have, stomach pain they can have, loose motions they can have, mucus they can have. But if there is bleeding in the motion, or there is something like fever, loss of body weight, loss of appetite and all this, then it is more likely to be IBD. So that time we have to thoroughly investigate and then treat it as an IBD. And people who have been treated with IBD, who have got rid of IBD, when you do biopsy, okay, they have got rid of IBD or it has completely subsided, still they can have symptoms of IBS. So this is one more new entity. What they are saying is, after IBD gets cured, still they will have the symptoms of IBS. That is, bowel irritation is still persisting, though the disease has subsided. So the next question is, people have got IBS, diagnosed as IBS, and then can it turn into IBD? That is one regularly asked question. All stomach pain and loose motions, is it because of IBS? It's not that any stomach pain and loose motions are IBS. There are many infective conditions, bacterial infections, amoebic infections, viral infections can cause gastroenteritis. So that inflammation it causes, and they cause the same symptoms like stomach pain and loose stools, and then that is not IBD or nor IBS. It is a viral or some infection condition. So it will be treated accordingly. Most of the infections will be temporary. As you treat it, you get rid of it. Amoebiasis is one thing which can prolong longer period, and that once it is treated completely, it is likely to get cured. But infections can happen repeatedly if you are always exposed to the contaminated food. The infection happens because of the contaminated food or water. So when you are eating food outside, you must be careful that you, roadside food and all, you must be careful whether it is all very cleanly, hygiene maintained properly, and water and all that, whether it is all clean water, it is a potable water, you have to decide about it and take. Otherwise, you are likely to get repeated infections and you may get it confused for IBS. How we make a diagnosis? Getting stool examination done, then we will know if there is any infection, all that through stool exam, simple test, motion test if you do, we'll be able to make a difference. Then how about IBS to IBD? So how to differentiate between whether it is IBS to IBD? If there is blood in the motion, you have to always consider IBD or some other disease. Even cancers can cause that. So blood in the motion cannot be IBS. If there is blood mixed with stools, we have to always think of some other disease. So then how to confirm it? First is stool examination. There are different tests in the stools. There is something called stool calprotectin. That is to differentiate between IBD and IBS. Then there is colonoscopy. Even you are suspecting IBD, colonoscopy is a must. We have to do something called colonoscopy. Colonoscopy is a small flexible tube-like thing will be passed through the anus, throughout the large intestine will check. There will be a camera at the tip, and then we will be able to collect all the information. We take a video of that and take pictures of that. And when we see something abnormal, ulcers or tumor, something like that, we take a biopsy through that, take a tissue for testing, that's called biopsy. And then pathologist will see it and say, this is IBD, this is cancer, this is ulcer, like that they will be able to make a diagnosis and treat accordingly. So colonoscopy is a must whenever we are suspecting IBD. People who have IBS, still if they have bleeding, we have to go for colonoscopy. Don't think that it is because of IBS. These are the differences between IBS and IBD. When you see mucus in the stool, what is mucus? Mucus is the secretions of the intestinal wall. If from nose when you are getting some, this one, that's also a mucus. So mucus in the intestines can come both in IBS and IBD. If it is only mucus and if it is not too much and if the other symptoms are not suggestive, it can be from IBS. But mucus mixed with stools and blood, we have to think seriously about other diseases, including infective diseases, IBD or even cancers. So simple mucus, that only for a few days, it may be some sort of infection. Mucus with a stool occasionally can be IBS, but when in doubt, better to do a colonoscopy and stool examination also.